For those who don't know, I'm Hollowtide, and if you find this video helpful, throw a like on it as it helps me get into that almighty YouTube algorithm. And if you want to join the community, make sure you subscribe, as I would love to hit 10,000 subs by the end of this year, and we are so close. That being said, this video is for those who are bronze to platinum ranked in Halo Infinite. If you're already Onyx, congrats, I don't think I'm going to be able to help you too much. But if you're hard stuck in diamond, then this might help push you over the edge and get you that Onyx rank. Ranked in Infinite is kind of a bit different than most games, in my opinion. From playing Ranked and from seeing others' opinions on the internet, it seems Halo Infinite prioritizes your kill-death ratio slightly more than just winning matches. If you win matches but consistently go negative, odds are you're not gonna rank up very fast in the current ranking system. Does this mean that you need to be a weirdo who only cares about their KD? No. Just try to combine the two, winning and doing well, to get the most out of your rank grind. I have some tips in this video to help you improve your gameplay, as well as some strategies with the game modes within the ranked playlist. So we'll be going over Capture the Flag, Strongholds, Oddball, and even Slayer. I'll also give you my biggest secret advice for drastically improving your odds at both winning and doing better later in the video. So first things first, we need to talk about the options that you have in the ranked playlist. There's solo, duo, and open, and you can also choose if you want to do mouse and keyboard or controller in the solo duo playlist. If you're a solo gamer, instead of selecting the open one on the menu, select solo duo and you'll only match with players who are either by themselves or with one other person in their party. Now, this may help you see a more positive result in your grind, but honestly, I've been playing mostly open crossplay, and I haven't had too many games where I was absolutely steamrolled by a full stack, but it's up to you. It's almost like a placebo effect. Now that that's out of the way, let's get into some tips and tricks. Look, I get it. You don't want to get on comms for whatever reason. I'm going to tell you straight up that communication will be the biggest factor in getting your ranks up. Any type of callouts or coordination will greatly increase your chances of survival, winning, and ultimately getting that higher rank. But maybe you're embarrassed of your voice. People call me Ben Shapiro every day in the comments, and I hate myself, so the last thing I want to do is get called Benny Boy in Halo. Maybe your kids are asleep and you can't be loud because you don't want to wake them up and make them cry. Maybe you are a girl who is tired of being harassed on the internet and during game sessions, and who can blame you? What if you just don't want to talk? Well, Halo Infinite has taken a mechanic from some other games that greatly helps out those demographics, and that's the ping system. It's amazing, really. You can mark enemies, objectives, weapons, areas, Halo 4 Cortana, vehicles, and so on. Now, this isn't quite as good as being on voice comms, but it can greatly help your team. Use it. Please, for the love of God, just use it. Honestly, that's the secret advice. Next up, we're going to talk about game modes, whether it's Capture the Flag, Strongholds, Oddball, or Slayer. Each game mode is extremely different from the others. And if you're playing by yourself, I can't stress enough how important it is to not just sit at your flag playing quote-unquote defense. Capture the Flag is all about push and counter-push. Getting a pick and Capture the Flag because of the long respawn time is extremely important. If you get a double kill, that's a huge 4v2 situation that your team has to capitalize on. And if you aren't working with your teammates or doing the bare minimum with the ping system, the enemy team can really steamroll you. Now, the end result is obviously you want to capture the flag, but the sub game of that is controlling the map. A good capture the flag game will see players establish dominant map control throughout the game and keeping that pressure on the enemy team. So please, again, don't stay in the back of the map thinking that you're playing defense, because that's just going to make your team do 4v3 the entire match and just get steamrolled. Remember that you can juggle the flag, and it's an effective way to cover a ton of space super fast. All you got to do is use the button that you use to swap weapons and just keep throwing that baby. Go into training mode and practice it, and you'll be juggling in no time. Similar to Capture the Flag, Oddball is all about your positioning. If you and your team can find a power point to hold down the ball, hold it down. You don't have to move from there. And remember, you can drop the ball to actually fight back. Too many times, I've watched players just run straight towards an enemy, trying to melee them, and they just get gunned down. Don't do that. Now, obviously, this is up to certain situations, but knowing when to drop the ball and fight back is very important. Say two of your teammates are about to respawn up and three of the enemies are pushing you and your buddy. Go ahead and drop the ball, try to fight back so that your team has time to respawn and get to the power point to help finish up those kills. Did you lose like 5 seconds off the clock? Yeah, maybe, but now that you've guaranteed you'll get more time, it's a net positive. Just like in Capture the Flag, you can also juggle the ball around to move quicker. And if you're able to, you can jump off the map to reset the ball in case you have 4 of the enemy team members on you. Then you'll reset the ball to its original position and your teammates can probably pick it up. Next up, we have Slayer, and Slayer is Slayer. Always stick with your teammates, kill the players. Don't get in fights that you can't win. That's something that I preach on this channel. Running around the map alone, getting into fights against 2 or 3 players will only hurt your team. If you spawn up before your teammates, don't rush out. Don't try to be a hero. Wait for your teammates to come up and make a coordinated push together. Slayer's all about teamwork and team shooting to get that victory. Strongholds, man. My one piece of advice is to just try to hold 2 zones. I know a lot of people might yell at me for that, you know, 3 capping, you get so many points and stuff, but it's just too difficult, especially if you're playing alone. If you're in a coordinated team, go for it. What if you're just, you know, grinding solo in that playlist and only one other person has a microphone or something? Just go for 2. I think that Strongholds might be the easiest game to get steamrolled in, so good luck. If I could offer advice on a particular map, it would be Recharge. If you can get your team to focus on holding A and C, then B will be a hard place for the opposing team to break out of. You can just keep nading it, whatever. But I've had games in Strongholds where it's just not possible that we're gonna win. And then the advice that I have for that is to play for your KD. If it's absolutely apparent you're gonna get destroyed 250 to 30, make sure that you're not going 5-25 in the KD department. Some other tips that might help you out in your rank grind is don't chase. How many times have you been greedy and tried to chase for a kill only to be baited by an opponent into a teammate or ninja, or you've had grenades thrown perfectly in front of you and they take you out? It happens a lot. Don't chase. I know we touched on this before, but don't be a lone wolf. Some people can do it, and some people can also fly spaceships. Just because you can doesn't mean you should. More often than not, at the higher ranks, this will drastically hurt your team more than it will help. Yes, I know pro players can do it, but we're not pro players. Also remember that friendly fire is turned on in the rank playlist, so never randomly just throw grenades where your teammates are. Too many times I've played, you know, Oddball or Strongholds, and teammates just start wailing nades out and end up killing 2 of their teammates and nobody on the enemy team. And that is frustrating. So be mindful of where you throw your nades. This video is getting on the longer side, so I'm gonna go ahead and wrap it up. Maybe I'll make a part 2, but I hope that this video helps you on your ranked grind. I hit Onyx, I solo queued most of the way, and I'm not the best player in the world by any means, so if I can do it, more than likely you can as well. My name's Holotide. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, and I will catch you in the next one. Peace.